Hi, I'm Bill Spaulding. Welcome to WCS Money Tutorials. Nowadays, with interest rates higher than they've been for a while, you will read a lot about the inverted yield curve. This video will explain what an inverted yield curve is and why it predicts recessions. This video will also explain how you can earn both a good yield and have a great potential for capital gains by investing in the right securities. The yield of bonds depends on many factors, but the primary factors are interest rates, term length, and the credit status of the issuer. The yield curve focuses on plotting yield versus term length, keeping other factors affecting yield constant. Treasuries are used to generate yield curves because they have no credit risk, so credit risk will not affect the yield. But other types of bond yields can also be used to generate yield curves. The term structure of interest rates is a variation of bond yields with the terms of those bonds. Bonds with longer maturities typically have higher yields. The actual shape of the yield curve depends on many factors, but the main factor, as I will explain later in this video, is the federal funds rate. The yield curve is simply a graphic representation of the term structure of interest rates. Yields normally increase with the bond terms, as you can see in this schematic diagram. Yield curves come in different shapes and shift in different ways. Many of these changes occur because of shifts in the yield curve. A flat yield curve often occurs because a transition is occurring between a normal and an inverted yield curve, or vice versa. There are several textbook theories that attempt to explain the structure of the yield curve. I list them here, but I will not explain them in any depth because I think there is a much better and simpler explanation, as I will explain later in this video. To understand why bond yields vary with terms, you must understand that bond prices are inversely proportional to bond yields. The coupon rate of most bonds is fixed, so if their prices drop in the secondary market, then their yields will increase because they are paying the same coupon rate on a lower price, and vice versa. So the changes in yield over the terms of the bond occur because demand in relation to supply differs. Duration is a better measure of interest rate sensitivity, which is roughly the amount of time it would take to receive half of the present value of all bond payments. Duration is roughly proportional to the term of the bond. Since the bond term is easier to understand and is a known characteristic of the bond, yield curves are based on the terms of the bond rather than on duration, so that is what I will talk about in this video. But keep in mind that duration is a more accurate measure of the sensitivity of bond prices to interest rates. Bonds with longer remaining terms have greater interest rate risk, as you can see in this graph that shows how bond prices vary with interest rates for a 10-year bond versus a 3-year bond. When interest rates are rising, then the demand for longer-term bonds increases over that for shorter-term bonds, because longer-term bonds have a greater potential for capital gains when interest rates decline. This is why the yield curve inverts. As the news always points out, an inverted yield curve predicts recessions, since recessions always follow in an inverted yield curve. Some yield spreads are more predictive of recessions. Spreads using the forward rate minus the 3-month rate seems to be the best predictors of recessions, but the 10-year yield minus 3-month yield is also nearly as good as a predictor. The 10-year yield minus the 2-year yield is also pretty good, and I will use the spread because there is more information going back further in time that will be useful in showing the relationship between inverted yield curves and recessions. This bar chart shows there's not a lot of difference among the different yield spreads in predicting recessions. This graph shows the 10-year minus 2-year spread going back to 1976. As you can see, the spread drops below zero, meaning that the yield curve has become inverted right before recessions, which are shown as gray areas in the graph. The Federal Reserve is the primary influencer of interest rates. The Federal Reserve controls interest rates by controlling the federal funds rate, which is the rate that banks pay or earn by borrowing or lending in the interbank market. The federal funds rate determines all other money market rates and interest rates in general, including the interest rate on mortgages and consumer credit. The Federal Reserve sets the federal funds rate to either increase or decrease economic activity. Low interest rates stimulate the economy. High interest rates throttle the economy. The Fed's goal is to maintain maximum employment while keeping inflation to around 2%. The Fed usually increases interest rates to lower inflation when it grows too quickly or gets too high, such is the case now. Interest rates will only go so high. Continued high interest rates dampen the economy and increase the cost of federal borrowing. So the Fed starts lowering interest rates to maintain economic growth, so interest rates fall. Investors know this pattern, so they invest accordingly. They buy bonds with the longest durations or terms because these increase in price the most when interest rates fall. That higher demand increases long-term bond prices and lowers their yield, and this is what explains the inverted yield curve. As you can see in these graphs, plotting the federal funds rate with the difference between the 10-year Treasury note and the 2-year Treasury note, the yield on the 2-year note exceeds the yield on the 10-year note when the Fed significantly increases interest rates. This is when the yield curve becomes inverted. This is a graph of the actual yield curve of U.S. Treasuries in February 2023. Note that the yield curve looks normal for terms of less than 1 year, but that the yield starts to drop sharply, starting with the 2-year yield. Notice also that the graph is more complicated than the schematic diagrams of yield curves. This is because other factors affect interest rates. For instance, pension funds often buy treasuries with yields that match their liabilities. Nonetheless, you can easily see that long-term treasuries have lower yields than treasuries with terms of less than 1 year. So the Federal Reserve causes the yield curve to invert. When inflation gets too high, the Federal Reserve increases interest rates to throttle the economy. However, it takes time to slow the economy, so interest rates are held too high for too long, eventually slowing the economy too much, leading to a recession. Hence, high interest rates cause both the yield curve inversion and the recession. But since investors can react faster to higher interest rates than the economy, they quickly increase the price of long-term bonds, inverting the yield curve, which is why the inverted yield curve precedes recessions. So an earlier indication of recession is when the Federal Reserve starts raising interest rates to combat inflation, since this precedes both the yield curve inversion and the recession. So here is a good investment tip. When interest rates are low, buy stocks, because it is the only way to earn a decent return. Never buy bonds or funds based on bonds when the federal funds rate is near zero, unless you are willing to hold until maturity. Otherwise, bonds or funds based on bonds will decline in price if interest rates rise, which is far more likely if the federal funds rate is near zero. So when the yield curve inverts, that is the best time to buy long-term bonds. Many investors already know this principle, which is why demand increases for longer-term bonds when interest rates reach a peak. It is the best time to own long-term bonds. Keep in mind that even when interest rates peak, there will be some fluctuation in bond prices because other factors affect bond prices besides interest rates. It may be better to wait and see how bond prices change over time while interest rates are at their peak. Then you could set a limit order to buy in the lower price range. This graph shows how interest rates affect exchange-traded funds based on bonds, with different terms, in this case U.S. Treasuries. Note that the three Vanguard ETFs based on U.S. Treasuries were affected similarly when interest rates changed from 2018 to 2022, but the ETF based on long-term Treasuries changed in price by a much larger percentage, even though interest rates changed by only 2%. This reflects the greater interest rate sensitivity of long-term bonds over short-term bonds. Thus, long-term treasuries have greater price risk, but they also have the potential for much greater capital gains. This graph shows the potential profits that could be made with this type of investment. Suppose you had bought the Vanguard long-term treasury ETF at the end of 2018 for about $70, when interest rates were at a local maximum. You would earn a nice interest rate while holding the ETF, and because the inflation rate was low in 2019 and the early part of 2020, there was little risk that interest rates would increase during that time. When COVID-19 arrived, the ETF price spiked, reaching a high of almost $110 on March 9, 2020. When the Fed announced they were going to drop interest rates to near zero, that is when you sell. In this case, you could have earned almost 56% in capital gains in about a year and 3 months. Adding the capital gains and the interest would yield a return of more than 60%. Of course, the stock market also did pretty well during this time, increasing by about 38%. Adding dividends of about 2%, this stock market return is still considerably less than the return provided by long-term treasuries. Thank you very much for your time. If you liked my video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. I would appreciate any suggestions, so please leave them in the comments below. Check out my website at thismatter.com for more than 850 in-depth fundamental tutorials on personal finance, investments, and economics. Check out my books on money at williamspaulding.com. Thank you.